is smishing? How phishing via text message works. Don't let the cute name fool you. Smishing, a portmanteau of SMS and phishing, is a cyber attack that uses misleading text messages to trick victims into sharing valuable information, installing malware, or giving away money. Smishing is a variation on the email-based phishing scams that have been around since the 1990s. But one statistic explains why attackers are putting so much work into developing these scams. 98% of text messages are read and 45% are responded to, while the equivalent numbers for email are 20% and 6%, respectively. As users grow more overwhelmed by constant emails and suspicious of spam, text messages have become a more attractive attack vector, exploiting the more intimate relationships we have with our phones. In addition, people are often less watchful for suspicious messages on their phones than on their computers, and their personal devices generally lack the type of security available on corporate PCs. This new take on an old trick is becoming increasingly widespread, and smishing attacks can be broken down into three broad categories. Number one, attempts to trick you into revealing credentials. Smishers may try to convince you to give up a username-password combo or other confidential information that they can use to log into one of your online accounts. Bank smishing is one of the most lucrative and common types of this category of attack. Number two, attempts to trick you into downloading malware. This sort of attack parallels one of the primary endgames for email phishing, though the techniques are adapted for mobile users and mobile technology. For instance, a smishing scam that ran wild in the Czech Republic convinced users to download an app purporting to be from that nation's postal service. In reality, it was malware that could harvest credit card info entered into other apps on the phone. Number three, attempts to trick you into sending someone money. This version of smishing is more the domain of the con artist than the tech wizard, but it's still something that's a real concern. In one such attack, a woman received texts she thought were from personal friends telling her about a government grant she qualified for. In reality, this was a classic advance fee scam. The victim was told she had to pay a few $100s upfront for taxes to get the money. While those scams play on the victim's desperation or greed, some take the opposite approach, exploiting their generosity. One set of scammers sent texts to victims pretending to be a clergyman at a local church, collecting money for charity. In reality, they simply pocketed the cash. These examples should give you a sense of the effects of smishing. Attackers can plunder your bank account, install malware on your phone that gains access to your finances or your location information, or trick you into spending money needlessly. In a larger sense, these smishing attacks make it more difficult for financial institutions or others to have trusted communications with customers via text messaging, which is one of the most universal communications platforms in use today.